Let's move to our third topic, that is communication. Before understanding what communication is, it is very important to understand why are we understanding communication in the promotional aspect. Well, as already said initially, the four major tools of promotions are advertising, sales promotion, public relations, and personal selling. Well, all the four tools employed by promotions directly and indirectly involve nothing but communication. Hence, it is very important to understand what does communication mean and what are the various elements involved in communication. Having said that, communication may be defined as a process concerning the exchange of facts or ideas between people holding different positions in an organization to achieve mutual harmony. The communication process is a very dynamic process in nature rather than a static phenomena. It is a process which must be considered as continuous and dynamic interaction, both affecting and being affected by various variables. Having said that, let's understand what are the major elements for a communication process. They primarily being the sender, the ideas, encoding, communication channel, receiver, decoding and feedback. That is, it is a seven element or a seven stage process which starts with the sender. So who really is the sender? Sender is the person who intends to convey the message or initiates this entire communication process with the intention of passing the information and ideas to others is known as a sender or a communicator. In our promotional techniques, generally it is the seller who is the sender who wants to convey the image or information about its product or wants to convey information about the particular brand. Hence, he is the initiator for a communication here, being the sender. The second part is the ideas, which is the subject matter of communication. It could be anything from opinions to attitude to feelings to views to orders or suggestions. Here, generally, it is nothing but the product information which goes from the sender to the receiver, or in a vice versa channel, it can even go in terms of feedback of the product or improvisations or market report from the consumers to the seller. Third being encoding. Since the subject matter of communication is theoretical and intangible, its further passing requires use of certain symbols such as words, actions or pictures or etc. Conversion of subject matter into these symbols is the process of encoding. This is the step which is taken care of by the sender. The next step being communication channel. The person who is interested in communicating has to choose the channel for sending the required information, idea or message across. This information is transmitted to the receiver through certain channels which may be either formal or informal. Formal channels are the ones which are clear-cut, designed and authorized and designated by the organization. For example, the line structure or the soft structure. However, informal communication is the one which can happen at any random level across any divisions of the organization. They do not follow any fixed pattern. The next element is the receiver. Receiver is the person who is getting the information or the message or for whom the message is meant for. It is the receiver who tries to understand the message in the best possible manner in achieving the desired objectives. In a promotional strategy, the receiver has to get the main message of the product or the brand across. That is, understand the key uses of the product or the special benefits or features that the product has to offer. Or understand how this particular brand is different from the competitor's brands and what is its competitive advantage. The next element being decoding. The person who receives the message or symbol from the communicator tries to convert the same in such a way so that he may be able to extract or attach some meaning so that to understand the message completely. This is called as decoding. Obviously, this is the element which is taken care of by the receiver. The next and the final element being feedback. This is the process of ensuring that the receiver has received the message and understood it exactly in the same sense and manner as the sender meant it. Without this element, that is the feedback element, the entire communication process goes for a toss. Because, as initially said, Communication is not about just passing meaning and information, but more importantly, about passing the understanding from the sender to the receiver. Having said that, let's understand the various forms of communication. It basically can be communicated into two different heads: verbal communication and non-verbal communication. Verbal communication is that part of the communication which is explicitly spoken or written. That is oral communication or written communication. Oral is the one which happens with the help of phone calls or direct talking, speeches, etc. Whereas written communication is done through letters, emails, faxes, etc. And the second component being the non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication is the communication which accounts for almost 70% of the communication being taken place. This basically includes the body language, the silence, the smile, the posture, the gestures, the hand movement, etc. This is the non-spoken and the non-written part of the communication which plays a very important role in actually passing on the subtle information of the communication.